Oh man, I just ended up one day taking the kid to the gym because he needed somebody to go with him, and I took him and met my boy Jimmy Ford, my brother from another mother, and it just, next thing you know, I never left.
Yep,
you gotta get back. He was a young man, was out here, he was homeless. God kind of brought him out here from Philly, promised him the world as far as if he would box. And when he got here, you know, it wasn't what the guy said it was, and he didn't even have a place for him, so the guy ended up homeless. He was still hustling, he would still get up in the morning and run, and you know, do his little pull-ups and stuff, so I admired his work ethic. So when he asked me to come to the gym to support him, it was super easy, you know, to come and be here for him, to hold it down. I had no intentions on boxing. My whole goal was to come here to after I came, was to work on my stand-up for mixed martial arts, because I was, you know, I was a grappler. And we just wanted to come to the gym just to work a couple days a week on my stand-up. But I'm a little, you know, I'm a boxing guy. That was what I grew up watching. So it was an easy transition. Like, once I started, I couldn't stop. We're one of the best gyms in California. Raul Castillo mixed martial arts gym out of Half Moon Bay. We work there. We go over and work at AKA as well in San Jose. So Adam Piccolotti, Raul Castillo, Sam Timko, Leo, all them guys, Mike D, you know, all them guys, Matt, they all helped me out. So Charlene, Leah, all of them, they were good guys. So for me, they really helped me advance in mixed martial arts, because I had, you know, very little grappling experience. I wrestled a couple years, that was it. And they were all high level and they were all high intensity. So you either shit or get off the pot. So I had to, you know, sink or swim. I was swimming over there doing my thing, but boxing was where my heart was. So when you find something you love, everything else is easy to let go. Boxing is one of those things that I try to remain as humble as possible. So being 16-0, I understand that could change. I understand I'm blessed to be 16-0, and I understand that a lot of hard work by many people, not just myself, have gone into me being 16-0. So I just enjoy the ride, you know. Still got a long way to go. I'm very good compared to some guys, and I'm not very good compared to others. And my goal is to be one of the best in the world. And boxing, my aspiration is just to walk away from the sport one day and know that I've given it my all. Whatever God has in store for me, whatever is in God's plan will happen. Because if it was up to Laron Mitchell, I would have got one pro fight. My whole goal was one fight, and that was it. You know, and it was weird how that played out. So I ended up fighting and fighting and fighting, and now I'm 16-0, and you know, I'm fighting again in a couple months here. So, and in life, just to live life, man, with no regrets. You know what I mean? There are very few things that I regret not doing, but you can't change those things, but I can change things in the future. So anything I wanna do, I do. You know, if I wanna go somewhere, I work hard, I save my money, I go. You know, even if it is picking up extra shifts, or even I gotta pick up an extra job, whatever it is. You know, if my kids need something and I don't have it, I gotta work harder. So my goal is to live life with zero regrets, no regrets at all. I do everything for them, you know what I mean? My goal is to show my children never to limit yourself, but to dedicate yourself to everything you do full throttle. That way there's no regrets. You know, it goes back to the previous question. My son wants to be a farmer. You know, he wants to get a farm. He's gonna have to work hard, you know what I mean? And when he gets that farm, that's getting it is half the battle. Then he's gotta work just as hard, if not harder, to maintain that. And that's what I'm doing. Like, walking into a gym and getting started in boxing was easy. You know, this is the hard part, coming to train when you don't want to, having to train after a long night and get up early in the morning to come train and then go have a full day, you know, doing whatever it is, whether it be work or with the family, you know, the whole nine. So that's, they motivate me in that aspect. Plus, you know, those are my children, you know, my wife and my mother, my brothers, you know, my family. I just, you know, they're all proud of me, but I still want to make them proud, you know. Beautiful. It was beautiful. It was one of the absolute best business decision that could have been made. Because I actually had a contract with Goose and Tudor, and that at the time seemed like the best thing going. For me, no shade on the promotional company, but for me it seemed like it was a very good opportunity. But Thompson was just like the best, the absolute best situation for me specifically. And for all young fighters that are looking to advance their careers, I would always recommend Thompson Boxing Promotions. If you look at the fighters that have come through there, Tim Bradley, Jessica Lopez, Mauricio Herrera, they got the WBA champ, Danny Roman. They got a lot of fighters, and they know how to make you a champion. So that's who you should go with, from my recommendation. Not just because they're my promotional company, but the shows are beautiful. I love the people down there. I have a very big following down in Ontario. And even if I show up not to fight, there's still people that I recognize, and I dap it up and they show me major love. Good dude. He's a solid dude. He's a solid individual. He cared about more than himself, and his goal is to make this planet, leave the planet better than he inherited it. And by that I mean the people and the environment.